Hello guys, today we're going to talk about one of the most popular indicators, the Moving Average Convergence Divergence, or MACD. The MACD is a momentum oscillator that also provides trading signals, but however it doesn't provide any overbought or oversold areas because it doesn't have any upper or lower limits. In today's video I'm going to show you how the MACD is calculated and how to use it in your trading. The MACD line is plotted by subtracting a low period moving average from a high period moving average. Then a moving average of that MACD line is plotted in order to provide trading signals. Lastly, there is a histogram plotted that shows the difference between the MACD line and the signal line. Let's go back to cTrader and I'm going to show you exactly what I mean. Here we see that we have plotted a EURUSD 1-hour chart. If we go to function indicator button here and go to oscillators, we're going to find the moving average convergence divergences. It's called MACD crossover. So let's select this. The MACD indicator window is going to pop up where we see the following parameters. We can change the source of the indicator, usually it's always close. The long cycle is a period of the long moving average. The short cycle is a period of the short moving average, and the signal period is a period of the indicator of the MACD line. Let's plot the indicator. I'm going to show you exactly what we're seeing here and you're going to understand better. We have plotted the MACD with the default parameters and we see it plots a histogram and two lines. As I explained before, the blue line is the MACD line. We said that the MACD line is calculated by subtracting two indicators. We plotted an MACD 2612, so if we plot two exponential moving averages, the MACD uses exponential moving average. Let's plot the 26 one and let's plot one of 12 parameters. Let's give them a different color. If we subtract this yellow moving average, the small one, from the big one, we're going to get the exact value of the MACD. So when the distance of the moving average is getting bigger, the MACD is going lower on a downtrend, the opposite on an uptrend. This red line here is the signal line. The signal line is just a moving average of the blue MACD line. So if we change these signal periods to 5, it's going to go closer to the blue line because it's an average of that blue line. If we change it back to 9, the default parameter, it's going to go further apart again. We use this line to show, to give, MACD uses this line to give buyer-sell signals. The histogram here represents the distance between the signal line and the MACD line. When the MACD is above the signal line, it's positive, in the other case it's negative, and when they're crossing exactly on the cross, it's zero. The histogram is zero, as you see here. Now that we understand how the indicator is plotted, we're going to talk about how to use the indicator in your trading. The first and most famous way of using the MACD is trading the crossover. The crossover is when the signal line crosses the MACD line or when the MACD line crosses the signal line. In order to trade the crossover successfully, you need to be trading them in some context. You cannot just take all the crossovers because you're going to fail a lot. It's not that simple. Let's go to cTrader and I'm going to show you what I mean. We see here we have the blue MACD line that I talked about before. And the crossover is when this line crosses the signal line. The signal line is the red dotted line, the moving average. So we have a positive crossover when the signal line crosses from below to above, and a negative crossover when the signal line, when the MACD line crosses from above to below. This crossover, for example, is a long signal because the MACD crosses from below to above, and this is a short signal because the MACD crosses from above to below. As I said before, these signals need to be traded in context. You cannot be just taking all of these signals that you see here. You're going to just lose money. The MACD is supposed to provide you a signal after you've done your technical analysis. If you know you have established that you have a trend already, it's better traded in trends, then you can get the signals. For example, here we see that the price is doing lower lows all the time, so we have established that there is some sort of trend, so we can be taking those short signals only, not the long signals. This is another example. We have established here we have higher highs and higher lows, so we can be getting, we can get this signal, for example. This is a good signal. We are inside some sort of trend, so we're good to go. The next type of signals that we get with MACD is when the MACD line, the main line of the indicator, crosses the zero level. This is particularly useful for trading trends, and it's also very useful for understanding when the trend is finished. It's the same thing as two moving averages crossing over. So let's go to cTrader. I'm going to show you what I mean. Here we see the MACD line, the blue line, crossing the zero level. In order for you to look at this cross better, you can plot another indicator, which is essentially kind of the same thing, the MACD histogram. Let's plot one. Here, the MACD histogram plots the MACD line as a histogram. As you can see here, the blue line and this histogram here are the same thing. So, when the blue line or when the histogram crosses the zero level, we have the same type of signal. Let me show you the zero level here so it's easier for you to see. It's around here and around here. This signal is particularly useful, as I said, for determining the end of a trend. So in this case, where we have a trend that has started and we're trading with the trend, in the spot, in this spot exactly, where the MACD crosses the zero line, it's very very successfully showing us that the trend has over, has finished. So as you can see, we get all the trend. Same thing with this trend. It crosses exactly here, and we get all the trend. So it's very useful for understanding when the trend is finished. In order to see it as a trading signal, maybe you can see it for the opposite signal after a trend, to go long after a downtrend. It's not recommended to just enter with a signal to expect that the trend is going to come, because you don't know that the trend is going to come or not, unless you have some news that you're expecting or something like that. That brings us to the third way of using MACD. You can actually plot two different MACD indicators with different parameters. One of them is supposed to be giving you the overall direction of the trend, and the other one is supposed to be giving you the trading signals. This way you know that you're always trading with the trend, and you filter out a lot of failed signals. Let's go to cTrader. I'm going to show you what I mean. So let's remove this histogram, and let's actually plot another histogram, which has a lot bigger parameters. So we're going to find the difference between the 200 period moving average and the 100 period moving average. We're going to put the signal periods to 1, because all we want to do from this big indicator is get the direction. So you see here, when this MACD that I have plotted is above 0, then my trend is positive. When this indicator is below 0, then my trend is short, or negative, or short. This indicator is going to be showing you even the slightest slope. It doesn't mean that you need to have a very steep trend, but it's going to give you just the slightest slope, so you're going to be trading with the overall direction of the trend. So let's see this part, for example. The indicator is showing us that the price has a negative slope, something that we can see from the trend line here. And what we do is see the slope from the second indicator and get the signals from the fast MACD with the default parameters, but we're only getting the signals that go with the direction of the big trend. So we're going to be getting this signal, short signal again. Most of the signals are going to be successful because we're going with the direction of the trend. Same thing here, a long trend with MACD, we're only getting the long signals. Now I'm going to talk about the last way to use the MACD in your trading, and very popular way. The MACD is a great indicator to show you divergences. In my opinion, it's the best indicator that you can use for divergence. A divergence occurs when the price has a specific slope, but the indicator shows you a different slope. Let's go to cTrader. I'm going to show you what I mean. We're going to be using... let's use a histogram again. It's easier for me to show you with a histogram. So let's put the default parameters again. A divergence occurs when, as I said, when the price is has a specific slope, but the indicator has a different slope. So this is a very good example of divergence. See here that the price is going down. We have a trend line going down. And the indicator is also going down, but at some point, the price continues further down. However, the indicator has the opposite slope. It goes up instead of down. This is called a divergence. It's a difference between the actual price and the indicator. This is a momentum, actually. The indicator is showing us that the price, even though it's going down, is going down with a different momentum. It's losing momentum. So this way we can predict the end of a trend before the actual trend is finished, because before of the crossover. What we can do with momentum is most probably we're going to be closing our short signals. It's not wise to trade against a trend. If we want to trade long after this short trend, we should wait for the trend to finish and find a cross. Like here, when it crosses above zero, then we can enter long. But the divergence is useful for exiting in a very good place. In today's video, I talked about one of the most popular indicators, the MACD, or Moving Average Convergence Divergence. I showed you most of the good ways to trade the MACD. I showed you how to trade the crossover, how to trade the MACD crossing the zero line, how to use two different MACDs to get overall trend direction and signals. And I also showed you how to trade the divergence with MACD. In the next video, we're going to talk about the Elliott Wave Theory. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. And if you want, share it with your friends. Thanks for watching.